Welcome to an introductory video on the order of operations. The order of operations provide a specific order in which expressions need to be evaluated. Step 1 is to calculate within the innermost parentheses or grouping symbols. Step 2 is to simplify all expressions with exponents. Step 3 is to multiply and divide from left to right. It's important to make a note that these two have the same priority. We just multiply and divide as they occur from left to right. And then the fourth step, we add and subtract again from left to right. These two have the same priority. Now there are some acronyms to help us remember the order of operations. You may have heard the acronym, "Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally." I'm not a big fan of that because it makes it look like there are 6 steps to the order of operations, but there's really only 4. Again, step 1, parentheses. Step 2, exponents. Step 3, multiplication and division have the same priority. So this would be step 3. And then step 4, addition and subtraction also have the same priority. So there's really only 4 steps to the order of operations. So if you do use this acronym, just remember there are only 4 steps. Let's take a look at some examples. Now over here on the upper right-hand corner, I did put the 4 steps, P for parentheses, E for exponents, M and D for multiplication division, and A and S for addition and subtraction. So here we have 5 plus 2 times 4 plus 1. So the first step is to simplify within the parentheses. Well, there aren't any, so we just skip that step. Step 2, exponents, there aren't any, so we skip that. Step 3 is multiply and divide. So we need to find the product of 2 and 4 next. So we'll have 5 plus 2 times 4 would be 8 plus 1. And the last step is to add and subtract. So we have 5 plus 8, that'd be 13 plus 1. This equals 14. Let's try another. The first thing we need to do is perform the operations inside the parentheses. So here we have 4 plus 2. So we'll have 52 minus 6 times 3. The next step would be to simplify the exponents. There aren't any, so we skip that. The next step is to multiply and divide. So it would be wrong to perform this subtraction. We need to multiply 6 and 3 first. So we'll have 52 minus, this would be 18, and now we can perform the last step of subtraction. 52 minus 18 will be 34. Again, it doesn't matter how involved these expressions get, we're just going to keep following these 4 rules. So step 1, we'll simplify inside the parentheses. So 1 plus 2, this will simplify to 3. And I highly recommend rewriting the entire problem each time you perform one step in the order of operations. So we'll have 5 squared plus 3 to the third divided by, this will be 3. So we're done with step 1. Step 2, we simplify our exponents. So here we have 5 squared, that will be 5 times 5, or 25, plus 3 to the third would be 3 times 3 times 3. Which would be 27. So now we're done with our exponents. And the next step is to multiply and divide from left to right. So again, we need to perform this division before we try to add. So we'll have 25 plus 27 divided by 3 is 9. And then finally, 25 plus 9 is equal to 34. Let's try another. Okay, we could skip step 1 because there are no parentheses. Next step is to simplify our exponents. So we'll simplify 4 squared. That'll be 3 plus 4 squared is 16. Okay, the next step is to multiply and divide from left to right. So here we have a product and here we have a quotient. So we'll have 3 plus 16 minus 5 times 2 is 10, plus 12 divided by 3 is 4. And our last step is to add and subtract from left to right. So 3 plus 16 would be 19 minus 10 plus 4. And then we'll go ahead and subtract. 19 minus 10 would be 9 plus 4. And 9 plus 4 is equal to 13. I think we have time for one more. Step 1, we'll simplify inside the parentheses. So we're going to have 4 squared divided by, here we have 12 minus 11, that'd be 1, plus 1, that would be 2. Still raised to the third power, times 4 minus 3. Step 2, we'll simplify our exponents. So we have 4 squared, that's 16, divided by 2 to the third would be 2 times 2 times 2, that's 8. Step 3, multiply and divide from left to right. So we'll perform this division first. 16 divided by 8 would be 2. We're still on step 3, so now we'll multiply. 2 times 4 would be 8. And then finally we have 8 minus 3, which is equal to 5. Okay, I hope these examples were helpful. Thank you for watching.